Bang. Okay, Bang showed up, Mookie. Bang showed up, Mookie.
Yeah, what it is, man.
Hey, Bang, I know you heard this nonsense.
Where the fuck my son at?
Where Mookie at?
Where my son at? Bring his bitch ass up to the thing.
Hold on, we gonna drop. Hold on.
Where he at?
We gotta make a spot, man. Hey, we gotta make a spot, man.
Hey, Bang.
Hold on. Everybody calling for Mookie, man.
And listen.
Mr. Moss, let me tell you something. If you want to fill in for him, just keep running.
You afford to be a rival, motherfucker. I gotta lose something. I ain't lost shit. This nigga mocks. This nigga stealing all my shit, nigga.
Mute everybody, Mike Lungo.
Hey, Bang.
T-Streets, you know I'm trying to get Mookie in here. Why you gonna come in?
I'm a cult, nigga. What's happening?
No, I want smoke, nigga. I want smoke with Bang. What's up, nigga?
That's T-Streets.
Hold on. Nigga burn Chicago, nigga.
Shout out T-Streets, man. Hold on. We trying to get Mookie in here.
Oh, what up? I'm back out of my I'll just fuck with y'all.
Hold on. We trying to get Mookie in here, man.
Hey, Bang, I got a question.
And we going to do the real head-to-head debate if he pull up.
Bang, I got a question for you real quick. Yeah. Lamar already answered this earlier. I just want to get your take on this. How come nobody mentions, you know, Jordan's first 6 years in the league?
Hold on. Lee, hold on. This is what we're going to do. Just so he don't cry foul. I know y'all in the backstage. Y'all just got to listen for now. I just want nobody crying foul. Right? We just go keep it LeBron and Jordan.
Hey, let me cut this little coat.
Hold on, y'all. I'm going to let y'all throw y'all shots. If you
man, want stop fucking muting me, nigga.
Hold on. We do the debate right way.
Calm swallowing ass nigga, man. Nigga, easy word, nigga.
All right, move.
Man, you a bitch, nigga.
Hold on.
Man, you a hoe. You a hoe. You a cult leader. You a hoe. You a fat, fat, tully tubby, titty worm, bitch. You a little nigga. I own you, nigga. You a hoe. You got blonde sexual dick on the side your throat. Okay.
Hold on, Bang.
You a hoe, bitch.
Bang, just hold on one second, Bang.
What you willing to die for, nigga? You don't know? Shut your whole ass up.
Tell us why Jordan better than LeBron. Let's hear it.
Man, listen. At the end of the day, nigga, I want to talk about the failures of LeBron James, nigga. Fuck Jordan. See, this is what we can't do, nigga. We can't touch the greatest. Michael Jordan is the greatest, nigga. The fucking greatest. This nigga LeBron James has been complete no-shows in the NBA Finals, nigga. Name me a time when Michael Jordan went scoreless in the fourth quarter in the NBA Finals, nigga. Name me a time when fucking Michael Jordan, nigga, was scared to take a challenge, nigga, of guarding the post team best player, nigga. And then when he guarded goddamn best player, nigga, he got cooked. LeBron James got cooked, nigga, when he was guarding the best opposed team's best player, nigga. I already named you the shit, nigga, how many niggas that was averaging greater numbers than what LeBron James did in the NBA Finals, nigga. Fuck is you talking about, nigga? We seen serious, nigga, when LeBron James came up short, nigga. Real talk, nigga. Fuck is y'all the niggas talking about, nigga? We talking about he got his ass whooped in 2011, nigga. The Miami Heat had to change the fucking system for that motherfucker to operate, nigga. LeBron James is only successful in the LeBron James system, nigga. Where he has the ball dominant cradle, drive and kick, that's all he does. Drive and kick, that's what LeBron James does. That's the LeBron James system. But let me sit there and name you, since you want to go off of stats over facts and all that dumbass picked out booty and the shit ass shit. Let me go to stats to use it against you, nigga. First of all, LeBron James, right? Y'all call this motherfucker the greatest player of all time, nigga. He is the only player in NBA history to two listed below. 6'10" tall, and has missed over 2,800 free throws while making less than 74% of his career free throw attempts. But he the GOAT. He has the lowest 3-point field goal percentage in NBA history. 34.5% among players who attempted 6,000 career three-pointers. He is the
Hold on, Mookie, you got another round.
You not letting me talk, bro.
Mookie, you get 2 minutes, and then we go to the other person.
Man, you ain't letting me talk, bro. I'm not done yet.
You got another round.
I'm not done.
You don't have to be done. Your time is up.
Lamont, you can't do this, bro. It's two two-minute rounds. Bro, you can't do this.
You get another round after this is done. Go ahead, Bang. It's your time.
Check this out, man.
Why did he run again, man?
That weak ass shit. This little nigga talking ain't talking about nothing, man.
Go ahead, man.
LeBron James, he scored more points than that nigga. Okay, Jordan might have a higher points per game, but LeBron James is a much more efficient player. Okay, he better from three. He averaged more assists. He do better rebounding. He just all around better. And then in the playoffs, when it mattered the most, LeBron James just made his mark, nigga. Jordan never beat no real champions. He didn't beat Hakeem and Magic. He beat Bloody Dibok in Magic. Okay, Bird stomped his ass out. Isaiah was beating his ass out. But until Scottie Pippen got there and Phil Jackson, he wasn't shit. Jordan is a system player, just much like Tom Brady. He's nothing, nigga, without that white massa and Tex Winters, okay, in that triangle. He's not a floor raiser like LeBron James. LeBron James is the ultimate floor raiser. He takes trash and bring it to the finals. And where do you make your name? In the playoffs. Who got the most game winners in the playoffs? LeBron James, not Michael Jordan. In fact, you could put Kobe and Jordan together and Stephen Curry, and guess what? They don't have many motherfucking game winners in the playoffs like LeBron James do. You understand me? LeBron James, the only nigga to average a triple-double in the finals, nigga. In all five statistical categories, he beat a 73-19, and he led both teams in everything. All five statistical categories. Michael Jordan is a system player. He never won without Phil, okay? All the people that Jordan played with three... He was on his team. It was three top 75 players and a Hall of Famer with the best coach in the weakest era in the 90s. And y'all niggas, Craig Elo, okay? Mark Price, Thunder Dan, Hershey Hawkins. You understand what I'm saying? Them niggas is weak, bro. They weak-minded just like you, bitch. Regurgitating the white Skip Bayless and the black Skip Bayless. You a hoe, nigga. You my son. You will never be me, nigga. Pay me my homage, nigga. Pay me. I built your shit, nigga.
Okay, that's time. That's time, Bang. Cool out. That's time, Bang. Hold on. Now, hold on, Bang. Now, Mookie said he dropped out. He said he didn't run.
He dropped out. That nigga ran like a bitch.
Okay, so, now, Mookie, we do two-minute rounds. Remember, we
bring your bitch ass back up here, nigga, and get some more school.
You got another round. You got one more round.
Bring your bitch ass back up here and get cooked up some more, nigga.
Okay, Mookie, you got to come strong, Mookie. You got 2 minutes. Now, look. I can put the clock on the screen. Some of y'all keep trying to lie and say it's
hey,
not.
I feel like my bad. I feel like.
All right, hold on, Mookie. Hey,
now this nigga said nothing but
2 minutes, Mookie. Mookie, your time starts. Your time starts now. Let's go.
Brian Sexuals love to mention Jordan early years without Pippen. That's what they want to do. Because that's Brian Sexual. That's what they is. All right, to find the definition of that shit. But let's look at Jordan first 3 years compared to LeBron James. The first season Jordan faced a 59-23 Bucks as a rookie in the playoffs. Let's compare that shit to LeBron James. Let's look at first season where LeBron James made it to the playoffs. Oh, I forgot. The nigga missed the playoffs. The second season, Jordan missed 64 games, faced Bird in the 67-15 Celtics in the playoffs, nigga. Let's look at LeBron James' second season, nigga. Oh, he missed the fucking playoffs, nigga. Let's look at the third season at Michael Jordan, nigga. Michael Jordan, his teammates was on crack cocaine. They both got goddamn kicked out of the goddamn team for sniffing crack cocaine due to drug issues, nigga. But look what Michael Jordan did in the playoffs, nigga. He faced Bird in a 59-23 Celtics in the playoffs. Let's look at LeBron James' third season. Oh, this is the first time he made the playoffs, his old bum ass. First season in the playoff appearance, nigga, he went against the 42-40 Wizards, nigga. Averaged 5 turnovers a game as a team, nigga, in the playoffs, nigga. So when you break this shit down between Jordan and LeBron, Jordan accomplished more than LeBron James in earlier years, nigga. And that's him retiring, nigga. That's him leaving the game and shit like that. He came back, nigga, three-peated, retired, came back, three-peated. Why this bitch-ass nigga having multiple meltdowns in the finals, nigga? Jordan ain't never, and I mean never, had a 2011, nigga, on his resume, nigga. Jordan ain't never make that shit go past six games. You know why? He a fucking killer. Why your niggas a quitting bitch. He's a quitting bitch, nigga. We see LeBron James be passable in the fourth quarter, nigga. We seen him give up shots to his key players. Why everybody blame the goddamn players. We seen LeBron James fold in the NBA Finals, nigga. Now that's let's time. Look at this. Hold on. Let's look. Okay, go ahead.
That's time. I got easy work, nigga.
Y'all niggas, Mookie. Easy work.
I just want you to know, LeBron James shit. Mookie, when I stop you, it's not because I'm trying to cut you off.
All right, go ahead.
This nigga easy work, nigga. All right, so it's on Bang. Bang. You got 2 minutes, man, to finish it off. Then we're gonna go to the vote in the chat, right? We're gonna let your chat decide. Then we're gonna bring the guys back up in the backstage, and we're gonna have every person get their thoughts on the debate. But Bang is your final round. I know you're gonna make it epic, but we gotta hear it out, man. Go ahead, Bang. Your time starts, man. Go ahead. Bang. My bad. I had you move. Go ahead and start over.
You wanna talk about easy work, bitch? Get your speech right. What the fuck is Listerine, nigga? Okay, but anyway. LeBron James, man, in career win shares, regular season and playoffs, he's number two behind Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, while Michael Jordan is fifth. Okay, LeBron got more Player of the Month awards. Okay, he played against the tougher competition in the finals. Okay, the period of dominance between the Golden State Warriors up there twice at 79% and 77%. Then it's the Chicago Bulls from 94 to 98, 75%. Okay. He never seen a team like the Warriors, but LeBron did. LeBron beat a 73-9 team. You want to talk about the clutch? You know what I'm saying? LeBron James is much clutcher in the playoffs. Okay, Jordan don't have as many game winners, like I said before. And without Scottie Pippen, Michael Jordan has no championship. He has no finals appearances. He has no semi-conference finals appearance at all. He haven't beat Bird at all. Okay, that shit matter, nigga. The 80s, to me, is the greatest motherfucking era. Okay, and he didn't win in there. He got spanked. He got spanked by Isaiah. LeBron James got the best motherfucking statistical postseason ever in 09. Okay, nobody has a better statistical postseason run than LeBron James. Nobody. Okay, LeBron James has never been carried like Jordan has been carried with Scottie Pippen. If you look at the playoff total finals, okay, only thing Jordan won in, led the team in, is in points. Scottie Pippen led in rebounds, assists, and steals and blocks. Easy motherfucking work. You want to talk about easy work? Nobody led in LeBron shit except one thing, and that was blocks. He didn't have the most blocks. Okay, in 15, if you match up LeBron James first 15 years with Michael Jordan first 15 years, he has a better shooting percentage. He has more assists. He has more rebounds. And the only thing Jordan got is 2,000 more points than him. At the end of the day, he can't fuck with LeBron James. In the playoffs, LeBron James is number one in all. He's top five in 40 of all the motherfucking top five categories that's important. That you put everything together in. Okay. At the end of the day, while LeBron James been in the league, ain't nobody won more championships than him.
That's time.
Nobody, bro. That's all he got, bro.
Nobody. All
right, so who we going?
Man, this nigga Ghost Town debate better than this shit. What the fuck?
Hold on, bro.
Man, this nigga. Hold on, I'm not done. Can I go another round, bro?
Hold on, Mookie.
I was gonna rebuttal what the fuck he said, because he lied.
Mookie, I'm gonna give you a chance.
Hold on. He lied. Mookie.
Hold on. He lied.
Okay, go ahead.
Mookie, hold on. We gotta go around. This one, I'm gonna bring it right back to you here in 1 second. Just say, hold your one thought. We're gonna start with Renegade. Renegade, you heard?
Now you got these. Hold on.
This is what we do with the debate. I told y'all we get bring everybody back in. We get their opinion, and then we look to the results in the chat. So, Renegade, you heard the debate.
It's cult member easy, nigga.
Who do you believe won the debate, Renegade? We're gonna start with you.
Man, he didn't even argue for MJ. All right, he used his little hate, and that don't help MJ. You know what I'm saying? So Bang.
Yeah, that you gonna go with your daddy Bang? Okay, go ahead. Nigga.
Okay, you can't get mad. Hold on, Ralph.
Dick out your mouth.
You come swallowing ass, nigga, man.
Niggas,
Ralph,
dick
out. Hold on, Ralph.
That's what it is, man. You got
surprise sex.
So go ahead. LeBron's my fault. You got cooked.
Hey, listen, listen. I'm doing better. Hey, Bang. You a bitch. You a whole ass nigga.
I really gotta say something.
Hey, no, no disrespect. No disrespect to the
bro. First, you gotta tell us who won the debate.
No, hold on, Can I respond to what the cap said? He said,
"Hold on, Mookie. We don't let you respond, Mookie.
You can't really follow the debate because both of the brothers is talking at the same time."
All right, hold on, Wally, just tell us who you thought won and why, please. Let's just get back.
You really can't hear what they say.
Big Daddy V ass, man. That nigga, man. Hope.
You understand? It would be best if you mute one of their mics, and then we can hear the argument.
I don't, but I can't. I can mute them
all. This shit over, bro.
What I'm saying.
I'm trying.
I'm just listening, right? I can't hear what neither one of them are saying because they both clashing against one another. Right? You can't hear them.
Oh, they already debated, Wally.
It's over.
Okay. Yeah. Hey, look, I just got here, brother. Hey, look. Let me just drop this on you real quick, Lamont. Hold on. Let me just say this real quick.
He gonna sit there and say Jordan had niggas carry him in the finals. LeBron James had four teammates.
Hey, Lamont, you see these dudes ain't never been on a basketball court, yo. You see that?
I was across the fuck out your bitch head.
Nah, bro.
Wally was an all-star, my guy.
Wally
was that dude.
I'm the real deal. It is what it is.
Wally's
the whole thing. Take that away from me. Hey, look. In Washington, D.C., where I live, I'm a living legend, brother. That's what it is.
He is.
And guess what? Hey, Lamont, you got a young lady on your panel, right?
Yeah.
She from D.C., right? Cool. I don't know her name. I think she's an authentic spot in DC, right? It's called Berry Farms. They play basketball over there every summer.
Yeah, they do.
Hold up a second. Let me get it. Y'all can have your point. Hey, I'll shut up after this. They play basketball over there every summer, Lamont. It's a hot spot. When I come over there, hey, look. They show me respect and they pay homage, right?
Congratulations.
And that's where I look. And if anybody here from DC, you know I'm not.
Come on, let them cook.
Yeah. Oh, I'm not capping because Lamont got a girl. You got a young lady from DC. Yeah. Oh, you can verify what I'm saying. Yeah. And anybody want to come to Berry Farms with that bullshit, I guarantee you can get a real good, decent flavor of Washington, DC basketball. And then y'all got, right? It's called Berry Farms. It's in the heart of D.C. It's the hood. Now, if you ain't got no hood with you, when you get there, look for me. And then you can come on in.
What's happening with that tournament?
Your basketball card, we can't take your basketball card away from you. Wally was definitely a hoop.
No,
man.
Fuck me. I'm talking about Washington, D.C. Man. I'm from D.C.
I've been in Berry Farms, bro.
We got two people in the area, Wally.
Who is this talking? Tell me they've been in Berry Farms. Who is that?
He in Baltimore.
This MLE. I've been in Barry Farms. I know niggas down there.
You know, okay. Can you agree that
I got the text message that my son was up
can
here.
Can you agree
that
I'm telling the truth?
Whoever.
Hey, hold on, Bank. Hold on, Wally.
This guy with the
Wally, hold on. Wally. We got to get to the rest. Hold on, Wally. Let me go to Spiffy. Spiffy, you heard the debate.
I just want to drop that on you, brother, so you have something, brother.
Yeah, we know you're official, Wally. You know that. When we joke, we talk. We know you're official. Hold on, Spiffy, you heard the debate.
Personally.
Who you got who won that debate? Who spit the most facts? Who made the most legitimate points? Who you got?
I got Bang.
Bro, do you know, bro? Hey, mom. All right, this is not a. Hold on. This is not. Hey. All these fans in here are Bron sexual. Bro.
I don't know.
You got the Bron coach.
You can't get mad. Hold on.
You got a sexual infection. You fat ass.
Hey, why you can't let a nigga have an opinion, man? Let me see your titty.
You got titty, nigga. Titty, nigga. That's 5X. That's 5X. That's a large.
You
got
titty, nigga.
Hey, Lamar. You my ass, bitch. You can grind.
Hey, Lamar, can I roll real quick?
Hold on. Go ahead, Lee. Tell us who you won, Lee. I gotta mute him.
Let the man finish the process.
Okay.
Come on, y'all. Hold on. We got Lee up. Lee, you heard the debate. Who you think won and why? Tell us why.
Okay. Well, first and foremost, I have Kareem as the GOAT, but that's neither here nor there. I have Bang won. It wasn't even close. He just had more. He had more substance in his argument, had more compelling facts, and it wasn't about feelings.
Right.
That's why. And for a record, man, forget it.
Hold on. Let's go to Ralph Lauren. I know what you're saying. Ralph Lauren, who you got? Because I know Ralph Lauren. You know, Ralph Lauren is, you know, he say his mind. He don't give a fuck. Ralph Lauren.
Hey, where Ralph Lauren play at, my man?
Come on, hold on. Don't Wally. That's not starting. Come on, Ralph Lauren.
Come on,
you there?
Ralph is asking a question, man.
Wally, you there? Ralph Lauren. Hold on, Wally. You heard the debate. Who do you think won the debate between Bang and Mookie, and tell us why?
Well, it was Bang. Like Lee said, it was more compelling, and it wasn't about feelings. About, like, you ain't hear hatred in his voice for Jordan. Like, it was like facts. Like you ain't hear no bias shit.
Okay, so we got three people so far said Bang on the panel. We got Sturdy. Sturdy, man, is the stat man. He come with all the stats. Sturdy, who you think won that debate, and just tell us why?
I think Bang won it because this argument is more structural, and also he actually replied to Mookie. Mookie didn't reply to any of his points. Well, he replied to his points, but Bang replied more to his points, had more structured argument, and most importantly, like, he actually gave both sides the argument. Mookie kept it one side in regards to LeBron's failures, then opposed to Jordan's greatness, which when you debate a player, you're supposed to tell what they great at and what they can actually do. I got from Mookie's side was more so what LeBron didn't do than opposed what Jordan did do. So that's why I got Bang winning, because he had a more structured argument.
All right, well, we're gonna shut the poll down. So for the chat, if you haven't made your vote yet, the poll is gonna be closing pretty soon. So make sure you get your vote in on who you think won, because that's gonna be the main vote that determines who won this one right here. We're gonna go to MLE. You heard both sides. Who you think won the debate and why?
Yeah, look, bro, was Mookie, when he was starting off, he was spitting facts. Jordan first 6 years and shit, making the playoffs and all that. But he left out the part where he spoke about it, but Jordan missed. He only played 17 games, and Gervin led them to the playoffs and shit like that. But when Bang responded, he spoke on that, and he told facts. And Shorty only talked about one final failure when he just kept saying, like, he keep failing, he keep failing. You just speaking off your opinion, not providing no facts. Bang was providing facts with the shit he was saying. Like, he had an argument. He just started getting in feelings. So that's why I'm going to go with Bang, because he started providing facts. Like, I just Google the shit Bang was saying. I can't Google everything Yo was saying. I just Google the first part he was saying, yeah, because I already knew this shit. But the rest of the shit he was saying, he just started getting in feelings. So I'm going to go with Bang.
Damn. Okay, we got Michael Lamb wasn't here. All right, so I think we heard from Spiffy, Lee, Lance, Ralph Lauren, Renegade, MLE. I'm going to give my thoughts. Look, when I first heard Mookie giving his take, I said, you know what? I like the angle that he's going with, because right. The first thing he has to do, like, I got to look at it like a gym. The first thing Mookie has to do is he has to clarify what the fuck was going on in Jordan's first 6 years, because that got to get explained. But he did a very poor job of explaining it. I think he could have did a better job. I think the first thing he kind of lied about was he talked about Jordan's teammates all being coked out. That's not necessarily true, right? That's right. Not necessarily. And just because you heard it in The Last Dance, yes, but Jordan was really focused. There was only one. There was one player on that team that did have a cocaine problem, and you're talking about a guy that was barely getting into the rotation. So it's not like that particular drug issue within the locker room was affecting on court, because it was a guy that was playing like 2 minutes a game, if that. So it was not one of your starters being affected. It wasn't key rotational players. It's just that, look, one of the things you have to admit when you're talking about Jordan is he's not the player that you need. If you have a bad team, you can't put him on a bad team and expect him to uplift and galvanize the other guys and make him play better. All right.
Come on.
And so that's just one of Jordan's weaknesses. But that's before one of LeBron's strengths.
Before you move on, I want to let everybody know this. I do not have LeBron as the GOAT. He is not my favorite player.
Facts. And that's for a lot of us. So what I'm saying is, I think Mookie could have did a better job of really explaining what went on the first couple years with Jordan. I think he tried to put he put a little cap into it by bringing up fake narratives that he heard on The Last Dance, which if you go back and fact check it, it doesn't really pan out to be that true. Bang, obviously, but yeah, Bang did a good job of focusing on what the things that made LeBron LeBron, right? It seems like Mookie was so harped on finals, playing bad in the finals, that I think that's a losing argument, because there's really no numbers or metrics that support LeBron James being a bad player in the finals. You might be able to point to one series or a game here or there. But outside of that, LeBron James has been to so many finals, he has a larger sample size to compare than others. So because he's been to more finals, he has more games for people to critique. And I think that makes it kind of unequal there, because LeBron just gets there more often. So to try to harp on the finals, I think Mookie would have made a better case by maybe getting off the finals. And yeah, you talk about the playoffs, you maybe talk about some of the regular seasons, but I think he was so stuck on the finals, that was a losing argument. You can't really win trying.
I thought he was going to catch more on the finals a lot, man.
Hold on, 1 second, Wally. I'm just trying to explain what I thought here. So again, Mookie did an okay job in the beginning. I felt like he started to break down and especially in that second round when it seemed like he was searching for things to say. So I think instead of going with stronger talking points that would have helped him, he ran to the hateful talking points. Just calling him out his name, continuously saying he failed in the finals when, remember, these are not the things that define players. Like Larry Bird has messed up in the finals. Magic has messed up in the finals. But nobody defines these players for it. And so I think, to me, it hurt his argument.
It's the full body of work.
Yeah, it's true, Wally. It's the full body of work.
Full body of work.
And you can't just sit there and harp on one thing.
You just can't nitpick. You can't pick what you like and what you dislike. It's the body of work, brother.
And look, and even if you don't like LeBron, the one thing you can't take away from him is that full body of work. That's the unfortunate part about it. You have to give him credit.
Full body of work, man.
That's my thought. So I thought
he defers, man. He defers in the finals, man.
Damn, hold on.
Hold up. If you know anything about basketball and you play 3 minutes to go, it's supposed to be LeBron down the stretch, bro. Point blank. Y'all was talking about,
man, that's a old white man.
Hold up, that's some yes, some man. Number one option.
Fuck out of here.
Last week or whatever,
we got more motherfucking cut shots.
It's a team game. The Magic didn't even do that.
Down in the stretch, down in the stretch, 3 minutes to go. That ball supposed to be in LB's hand.
Yeah, but Wally.
But it is in his hand.
But Wally, LeBron has the most game winners.
Hold on, Wally, but it is in his hand.
Say what?
He has the most game winners. He has the most clutch shots.
Hey,
hold on, hold on. Let me give y'all the results.
Hold up. He looked.
No, hold on, Wally. Wally, listen.
He's looking not to be the GOAT. And I'm not talking about
Wally. I'm gonna let you go here in a second.
So we get on with the show, man.
Wally, I'm going to let you go here in a second, Wally. I got to get to the results.
Hey, go ahead, man. You got enough.
I got you, Wally. I'm going to let you go as soon as I'm done. Wally, I got you. As soon as I'm done, I'm going to let you go. So, results of the poll. I'm going to end it right now. And, you know what? You know, Mookie, I know you're not going to like the results of the poll.
Landslide.
But, unfortunately, like, I've seen too many times on this channel.
Yeah, that 300 would have been mine, little nigga.
I've seen too many people with, like, I've seen GOAT Mike win a debate against Mac Def when GOAT Mike was having a talking point that nobody agreed with, but yet GOAT Mike came with the facts and won. So I know the chat ain't biased, right? Even if it is Mookie, but Mookie, you lost this one, man, by big time. Lance, this was definitely so, especially in the finals, Mookie. You flopped in the finals, man. When it was your time to show out, man.
Check what you
did. Easy banged with the blowout. Look, y'all, this is a blowout victory. Weezy Bang with 68% of the vote.
Bro, and, I can't and,
so, so that's and, a final sweep?
I'm undefeated, by the way.
And Mookie with 31% carrying Jordan. So Mookie again. Mookie,
oh my God.
Mookie has to understand. What y'all have to understand
from the three, huh?
Hold on 1 second, y'all. What y'all have to understand is debating LeBron is actually the harder debate. So it's much harder for Bang to go from his talking points to win this. Mookie has so many things he could have used that he didn't touch because of the hate. Now I'm not joking.
When
you're talking about
Bang,
Jordan. And, but hold on, Bang. And I asked Bang this. Bang. Am I wrong or am I right? Did he even break the glass on all of the things?
If I was arguing for Jordan, I wouldn't have said none of that goofy shit he said.
No.
He could have made a way better argument.
He could have made a better argument for Jordan.
That's what I do. You feel me? That's my son, nigga. I own that bitch.
Hey, Bang. Let me ask you a quick question. Why is it that, you know, as Wally and other people like to use that trash narrative about LeBron and not being clutch?
Because they've been listening to a white man for years and years that's 24/7 on TV hating on this nigga because he sucked Jordan dick. He got all fucked with
And Bang, that's what I was going to ask you, and Lamar.
Gatorade bathtub, nigga.
And Bang, that's what I was going to ask you.
He got panties on.
And Bang, that's what I was going to ask you. That's what I was going to ask you and Lamont. Why do people always disregard LeBron's game winners? Why do they always disregard LeBron's game winners?
Hey, because it ain't good enough for them. Like it my man B said, it ain't pretty enough. Fuck.
And Bang and Mookie, who I argue against?
But what I do to you and my team, I made you realize the truth, didn't I? I just give you the truth. I'm gonna disarm you with facts, nigga.
Hey, what's LeBron's excuse right now?
There ain't no excuse, playing. Nigga.
Hey, look, my man is doing all that talking, right? Is he willing to put some money down on LeBron winning a championship before he retired?
Come on, happy I ain't gonna be around. Hey, come on, man.